The following video is only a very basic introduction to VMware configuration. Depending on the major you go into next semester, you may be presented with additional labs on VMware. Those labs are designed to go into much greater depth than this introduction, so please realize that your use of VMware in this lab is designed to be very rudimentary. Let's start by customizing the desktop icons. Right-click in an empty area of the desktop. Select the Personalize option. Click the Themes option in the left navigation bar. Select the Desktop Icon Settings option under the Related Settings category. Check both the Computer and Network checkboxes at the top of the dialog box. Click the OK button. Close the Settings window. You should now see the two new icons on your desktop. Before we start working in VMware, we need to disable the wireless network adapter. VMware sometimes gets confused when it sees multiple network interfaces. You may use either a wired or wireless interface, but wired is recommended as it is faster and more reliable. Right-click on the network icon. Select the Properties option. Select the Change Adapter Settings option. Right-click on the wireless adapter icon and select the Disable option. Please note, disconnecting from a wireless network does not disable the interface. Close the Network Connections window. Close the Network and Sharing Center window. In this section, we are going to configure the hardware that will be emulated and tell VMware which OS we will be installing. Launch VMware Workstation. If you do not have an icon for it on your desktop, you can search for it using Cortana. Click the Create a New Virtual Machine button. Select the Custom Advanced Configuration option. Please note, this is a critical setting for the lab to be completed successfully. If you miss this step, you will not be able to answer a number of questions in the lab or on the lab exam. Accept the default settings for the hardware compatibility options. Select the I will install the operating system later option. Select the operating system you will be installing. In this demo, we are installing the 32-bit version of Windows 7. Enter a name for your virtual machine. Use a name that will make it easy to identify the purpose of this VM. Browse for the location you wish to store this VM. Make sure you create a folder for the VM, or VMware will put all the files for this VM in the parent folder. Accept the default settings for the number of processors and cores. Accept the default settings for the amount of memory. Select the Use Bridged Networking option for the network type. Accept the default settings for the I/O controller type. Accept the default settings for the disk type. Select the Create a New Virtual Disk option. Increase the maximum disk size by 20 gigabytes. Select the Store Virtual Disk as a single file option. Don't worry, you will not lose the amount of storage space specified. You are only setting the maximum size you will allow the file to grow to. Just make sure you do not check the Allocate All Disk Space Now option. Enter a name for the virtual hard drive file. Make sure you do not edit the file extension. It is recommended that you simply add OS to the original name that was suggested, so that you know this is the drive where the operating system has been installed. Review the summary and click the Finish button. We are now ready to point to the location of the installation files. To do so, we need to edit the virtual machine settings. Select the CD/DVD from the list of hardware. Select the Use ISO Image File option. Browse to the location of the ISO image of the OS installation disk. Your instructor will provide the location of the ISO image. Once you have selected the ISO image, click the OK button. That's it! You are now ready to power on your VM and start the installation.